A new lawsuit is in the works that alleges that doctors are pushing puberty blockers and unnecessary surgeries on young children without understanding or warning them about the risk, both medical risk and psychological risk. Join me to talk about this is Steve Luongo, ex-ball player, superb trial lawyer. Steve, I want to talk about the complaint that's been filed. We're not doing this litigation, full disclosure. This is not something we're doing. But I saw that there was a complaint filed, and there's actually been several filed now. Tell us a little bit about the case. First of all, what's happening with the gender case to begin with?
So the one that is on file right now is a similar pattern that we're seeing in the news, is that a young girl is confused about who she is around the age of 10 or 11 years old, and then goes to the adults for help, tells her parents and family, I want to transition. They then go to the medical facilities in their area. In this particular case, the case is against Kaiser right. and their foundation hospitals and the doctors that treat there. They are then given a psychiatric evaluation. They're given and diagnosed what's called this gender dysphoria, which is really the gateway to them being diagnosed and having the access to these puberty blockers, these cross-sex hormones.
Okay, according to this complaint, this has been filed, according to the complaint, Superior Court of California.
Right,
there's a couple of them already filed. I'm seeing them pop up around the country. This one, they're saying Kaiser Foundation is on the hook. They're saying the psychologist that worked with the child is on the hook. They're saying that the doctor that performed the surgery is on the hook. And counselors of every kind are on the hook in this lawsuit.
Right.
So what they're saying is that the child was 13 years old. She's now 18, and she says, A, you lied to me. B, you didn't give me full understanding what was going on. C, you put undue pressure on my parents to get this done. And now there's no way I can turn this thing back. These lawsuits are popping up. We've chosen to stay out of it because I don't know if it does, you don't want to slow the rights down of a person to get this kind of surgery. But like it or not, these folks that are doing this are being sued. Talk about it.
Absolutely. And the claims that they're alleging are malpractice claims against, like you said, the foundation, the facilities, allowing this treatment to go forward, as well as the doctors. And what they're saying is that it's too fast of a process. You didn't give me time. You didn't give me informed consent. You didn't give my parents informed consent. And the allegations that they're making here is one of them is
30 days. My memory is, was it 30 days they gave this person?
It's close to that. And in some cases that we're seeing, it's same day they're being given these puberty blockers or given scripts for the puberty blockers. And what they're saying and what the doctors are telling the parents, at least in this complaint, is that, do you want a dead daughter or a living son? Oh. So those are the choices
now,
that they're giving.
They're saying your daughter may commit suicide if we don't do this. And because of that, we had to do it. But here's the truth. According to this complaint, these complaints are all saying the same thing. This one, again, is a California complaint. But they're saying that Kaiser Foundation is building a cash cow around this business. They're saying that the people that sell pharmaceuticals are building a cash cow around this business. Everybody's rushing into the market. You've got psychologists and psychiatrists. According to this, now we haven't done, I can't speak to it. I haven't done the research on it. But if I read what this says, they apparently have done some research. And they say the psychiatrists and psychologists are making this into a cottage industry.
Right. And the research that they've done and the allegations, again, in the complaint are that you're giving these children puberty blockers, which are not approved by the FDA for this use. You're also then giving them the cross-sex hormones, which, again, are not used for this, not prescribed or approved by the FDA for this use. So those are the major complaints as to what the pharmaceutical companies are doing, what they're aware of, how their drugs are being used and given to a population that they were never designed to have.
Steve, is this a chilling effect, though? Is it if you start suing these people that are saying, I'm in this business, of trying to help. The numbers are startling. I mean, the numbers that we're seeing pop up are startling.
In 2021, 42,000 children were diagnosed with gender dysphoria alone.
42,000?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and so if we look at these complaints that are popping up, and they're saying that they're saying one thing I think is critically important, they're saying that the pharmaceutical industry that we do sue all the time, and we know how corrupt that industry is, hasn't even done long-term clinicals to understand what kind of effects this is having on children. The possibilities are bone density problems, leukemia, dysplasia of all different kinds, blood dysplasia. They're saying that if you look at what studies have been done, by people like Kaiser or these psychologists and psychiatrists that are saying, yeah, get this done. We don't really know what the risk benefit is. That's according to this complaint. And I think that's something that's popping up in all these complaints. I think that this is going to be a new trend. I think these folks are going to be sued into hell, to tell you the truth. Mm-hmm. And the problem I have with it is, what effect does it have on a legitimate case where a child wants to make a transition? They're not 12, they're not 10, they're 16, 17, and they have the feeling, I want to make this transition. Does it have a chilling effect? What's your take?
I think it will. I think it's going to cause these doctors to think twice about what their standards are. Because right now it's all over the board across the country. We're seeing significant legislation coming out in states restricting the care for minors. But there's states where they're sanctuaries and they're proud of that and advertising that. Come to our state, we're allowing this care for the kids.
Well, California's one of them. Maybe
exactly.
That's why these cases are popping up in California.
I think so. And what the complaint also goes into is what are the long-term psychological effects of these hormones on young kids and their future fertility. Fertility, okay. As that is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Wait, what, is it reversible? I mean, if a child that's 10 years old is... They start them on chemicals. Say they start the chemical transition. This goes through a pretty detailed kind of explanation. But when I read it, it appears they start them on chemicals. When they reach a certain age, then it's surgery that they say. What are the age groups here?
So typically the process that these clinics and what they're called are gender care clinics or gender facilities within these hospitals and universities, they start them off with either medical intervention with the puberty blockers around 10 or 11, whenever puberty starts with these young kids. From there, they can continue with those for long term for multiple years or transition into what's called cross-sex hormones, which are more advanced as far as stopping the process and actually creating the desired physical attributes that they want, the development of the cross-sex
genitalia. What if there's been surgery? What if you've had breasts removed? What if you've had genitalia removed? That's not a reversible thing, is
it? That is not reversible, and that really, I think, is what the heart of the complaints are trying to avoid and stop. What we see is that there was nearly 1,000 mastectomies of young girls under the age of 18, and that trend is going up.
Steve, isn't it like anything else? Okay, this is something that we have to have professionals that can do this. Okay, there's real, legitimate cases where it should be done. But then greed gets involved. Mm-hmm. And if I read this... As I read it, it is that all these folks that are involved in some form or fashion are creating a cash cow for themselves. The psychologist, the psychiatrist, they now have a client for life.
Right.
The chemical company, they have chemical, they can sell pharmaceuticals for life. Casa Permanente, you know, as these facilities go up everywhere, they have new customers. I don't know. I look at this. If I were in the business of this, and, you know, of course, this is... Our business is going after large corporations. They better have standards that right. They can present to a juror and they can say to the jury, look, here's what we did. Yes, she's now 21. She says that this is a horrible mistake. I was pushed into it. There was way too much undue influence in helping me make this decision. But if you have standards that say, well, not really, because here's what we did. This complaint says that there are no standards that really protect these kids.
Right. And that's what the complaint is alleging. That's one of the focal points of saying we need to slow down. And you talked about chilling effect earlier. I think that is the purpose of one of the many purposes of these complaints is especially in these sanctuary states where the care is being fostered, it's being endorsed. They want to chill that. They want to slow that down, get the standards that you're talking about, because it is a cash cow for them. The puberty blockers, the hormones, those are monthly injections, and they're thousands of dollars per injection.
Yeah, but the ugly part of it is the politics of it. I mean, you put money on the table, and you got corporations that are doing the greedy thing. Mm-hmm. You put social issues on the table, and you have lame-brain politicians that want to overreact, and they want to overcorrect. This particular area, my prediction is there'll be dozens and dozens of these cases filed within the next 24 months. That's my guess. Mm-hmm. We're not going to do it. I'm telling you that. We're not going to do it because I feel like at this point the chilling effect may be such that it could stop it to where people don't have a place to go, and that's a problem. Steve, right. Thank you for joining me. Thanks for reporting on this, okay?
Thank you. Uh-huh.
That's all for this week, but all of these segments are going to be available throughout the next week. And make sure you follow us on Twitter at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you the stories that corporate media won't tell you because their advertisers won't let them tell those stories, or because their political connections are so tied to a political party that that doesn't allow them to tell the story. But you know what? We will tell you that story. See you next week.